Today I'm going to be showing you how I farm a lot of exalts from Nemesis map. So far I have dropped two mirrors doing this, which is really nice, and I get a lot of exalts and scout cards as well. So basically I run a lightning strike build. I will put the link down on my POB in the description below. And also running MF Lightning Strike. So at the moment I have 74% and 251 rarity plus 45 here. So 296. And I also use the flask, which adds 12 to my quantity and 30 to my rarity. So I'm at about 326 rarity and 86 quantity with my flask on. So basically how I do it is my watchstone setup is a suffix, a prefix, misinformation, and booming populace. And I use an elevated beyond sextant, Nemesis 4, elevated Nemesis sextant, unique monsters drop corrupted items for all the six links, which is rollable using prime sextant, so you don't need to use your awakened sextant or anything like that. And I use an awakened sextant additional abyss. And for my Atlas passive, I just use the standard Beyond and Abyss. Uncharted Realm is pretty standard as well. You just want to get all the you know, mapping sort of passives. We're not doing bossing, so we don't care about Cirrus or anything like that. For the Scarabs, I use a Winged Divination, Winged Breach, Winged Abyss, and a Winged Reliquary. So let's put that in. For the prophecy, I use a Plague of Frogs. And I don't want to use Vaal Winds here because there's not going to be enough to loot the whole map with 6 links. So I use one of the other Tempest, which gives 30% item quantity if it procs. So we'll use Eyes from Above here. And the way I roll my maps is I try to get Nemesis and Beyond. So we want Nemesis and Beyond, as you can see here. And then I want to 6 mod it. If you roll it without 6 mod, then you go Beastcraft, add a mod to a map until you get 6 mods. I also put 3 Delirium Orbs. I use Fine Delirium Orbs, which basically pays for itself because you get up to 15 or 16 layers when you do the map. So let's take one without cannot leech. This one. Important thing to note is you can't afford to die, because if you die once, you might break the map and there's a chance you might not loot everything. So okay, so for the master mission it's always Alva if you're doing Nemesis, and obviously Beyond since it's a Zana mod this league, so it's mandatory. So this is the triple Beyond Nemesis 4 setup. Hopefully I didn't forget anything. And then we just go active it. I want to change my loot filter as well. So I use 2 loot filters. So I use one for just showing 6 links and some uniques, so that when I drop a 6 link, I loot them straight away. In case I die, I don't, you know, heavily brick the map that bad. Yeah, so let's do the run. So unfortunately we didn't proc a prophecy, which is bad, but it's alright. So on average, I'm getting about 5 exalts, raw exalts per map. That is including the scout card. So one scout card is, I think, 0.9x. So hopefully we can get around that this map. So I try to loot that straight away. And then I put that on my Krangler too, so I save some space. This build is quite tanky compared to the MF Deadeye builds, which is very squishy. Although it might clear a bit slower, but I'm fine with that. Like 2 minute more clear time doesn't hurt me much, because the time consuming part with doing this setup is the looting anyway. It's not, you know, clearing the map. So that's not a big deal. So we want to trigger the Abyss and the Breach. Hopefully I don't crash. I've been crashing a lot this league, especially when doing Breaches for some reason. The other thing to note is you don't want to trigger Abyss at the same time, and that is because there is a certain time frame that they expire if you don't, you know, kill the mobs or follow the Abyss, which is bad. You lose a lot of monsters, and because sometimes they go opposite direction, which is, yeah, really bad. So right now I'm at full inventory, so I could afford to die at this stage. I still prefer not to, because I'm trying to get to level 100. But it's alright if I die or if I crash, that would be alright. Okay, so now let's do Alva. So far we haven't seen an exalt drop yet, which is pretty unlucky. Normally I should have seen one by now. How many IIQ is this? This is a 176% IIQ map and 85% pack size, so with triple beyond, so it's pretty unlucky to not see an exalt at this stage. I'm already at 11 Deli layers, so hopefully we get one from this Alva. Doesn't look like we did get one. It's alright. Really laggy. Well, this is a pretty good Abyss so far. It's the fourth move, I'd say. But so far, still no scout or exalt drops. Hopefully this Alva temple gives us one. That'd be sweet. But even without Exalt drops, you still get so much loot on the map that it's really worth it. I think I've spent around 50x for 16 runs. Okay, so no Exalts again, that's fine. And we move on to the other side. There's one. So we got a scout. Another one, so it's two so far. Yeah, with the amount of six links that you get, you can turn them into divines. It's, I think, yeah, I get about 35, 36, 30 plus six links per map, or divines, with this setup. So the only problem you really have is, like, you know, looting the map. Which I probably wouldn't show in this video. I will show how much loot you can get. In fact, I'll put it on a stash and I'll show it at the end. What I got from, you know, running one map of this setup. And then we can check excellence for how much profit we got. So what we want to see on Alva temples are Beyond procs, which I didn't see much this one, so probably didn't. Nothing good. We should have quite a few more Abyss, I would think so. Oh no, oh yeah, there's another one. And we have another breach, so there's still hope for a couple more exalts. Depending on how good this abyss is, if it it did move, which is good. As you can see, this build is really tanky. It's like triple Deli map, fully juiced. You don't even see my HP go down, really. Follow the abyss for a sec and then we go back to the breach. It's not there anymore. It's fine. So we'll just wait for the breach to spread out and then we can come back to it. There we go. Hopefully I don't crash. Alright. Thirteen monsters left, so I guess yeah, that's what a map looks like. So now I'm gonna show you how much loot we got. I'm gonna try to loot some stuff here. So this is my uber strict filter, so I'm just gonna run through them while I'm looking for those 9 monsters. So you can see there's a whole bunch of stuff on the ground. There's a whole bunch of 6 links that I still need to pick up. I still need to check the uniques that dropped as well. If I got any Mage Blood or Headhunter or... what do you call it? A Squire. Let's loot these. So this map is pretty unlucky. So we only got 1X and a Scout. But that's fine. We should still... I'll show you how much total we got from this one map. Right after looting this video, you can see there's a whole bunch of shit in the ground. Right, okay, cool. Alright, so this is the total amount of loot that we got from that run. It was pretty unlucky, we only got 1 scout card and 1 exalt orb. But we still got around, how much is this, 6.21x from excellence, which is pretty good. So yeah.